In this short video, I'll summarize the concept of resources and capabilities. The resource-based view of strategy of firms was developed by Jay Barney, who suggested that resources and capabilities are the key drivers of a sustained competitive advantage and greater profitability. Tools such as Porter's Five Forces are useful for understanding industry profitability. However, economic performance is not just about looking at the external environment, but also a firm's internal environment. The main objective of strategy is to create a sustained competitive advantage. As mentioned earlier, a firm's resources and capabilities are the key drivers of a sustained competitive advantage. And so these resources and capabilities need to satisfy four key characteristics. It needs to be valuable, rare, imperfectly imitable, and organizationally exploited. A firm's resources and capability needs to add value to create a sustained competitive advantage. Here, the main objective is to increase efficiency. For example, a new IT system is valuable since it increases efficiency by increasing the number of calls an agent can answer. The second objective is to increase effectiveness. For example, opening a new regional campus increases effectiveness and enables outreach to a new market of students. Resources and capabilities need to be valuable and rare to lead to a sustained competitive advantage. If a valuable resource or capability is common and shared by many firms, it will not lead to a sustained competitive advantage, but rather a competitive parity. A firm's resources and capabilities needs to also be imperfectly imitable. If competitors have difficulty copying these resources, then firms are able to obtain a temporary competitive advantage. There are also four factors which can also make something perfectly imitable. First is due to uniqueness by nature and legal right, for example, patents. Second is due to a historical condition, for example, a resource obtained or developed due to a historical event which could not be recreated or obtained over a period of time. Next is causal ambiguity, which refers to a firm's unclear understanding why resources create value. And finally, social complexity, which results from trust, informal and interpersonal relationships and culture. By having resources and capabilities that work together, it makes it more difficult to be copied, and so a firm can obtain a temporary competitive advantage. Finally is the ability to be organizationally exploited. This refers to a firm's ability to exploit the full competitive potential of a resource or capability. In order for a firm to exploit a resource or capability, it needs to have its strategy, structure, and processes aligned to give its people an incentive to exploit the firm's strategy. A firm's analysis of its internal environment is as important as the external environment. We can see that resources and capabilities are the key drivers of a sustained competitive advantage and economic performance. Therefore, it is important to understand the four VIRO characteristics, which helps firms to obtain a sustained competitive advantage.
If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, leave me a comment below, share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you next time.
The product life cycle is a process of five sequential stages from introduction, growth, competitive turbulence, maturity to decline or extinction.